الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمدك اللهم سبحانك كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. نحمدك اللهم آناء الليل وأطراف النهار، معترفين بسلطانك، حامدين شاكرين لنعمائك. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يديم علينا نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة، وأن يلهمنا العزم والعزيمة والصبر والثبات على أن نحمده على تلك النعمة. اللهم أمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يحيي ويميت، وهو حي لا يموت، وهو على كل شيء قدير، شهادة قامت بها السماوات والأرض. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا يحرمنا إياها لحظة لقائه. اللهم أمين. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. اللهم جزيه عنا خير ما تجزي به مرسلا ونبيا. اللهم شفعه فينا شفاعة لا نعذب بعدها أبدا. اللهم اسقنا من حوضه شربة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم آمين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, no doubt the two major sources of the teaching of Islam are the Quran, the revelation, the wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Sunnah, the tradition of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, including his biography, his seerah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to learn from both and to have them as the best guidance ever, and not only to learn but also to educate our children, second and third generation of Islam, especially in this country, to follow the guidance of Allah, the Quran, and the guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sunnah. This does not mean that we stop at that point in our learning and in our education from the Quran and Sunnah. Also we can learn from the biography of the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with all of them. أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. These are the ones who are guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who do have the mind, the reasoning, they can think and reflect in order to be successful in the dunya and in the hereafter. All of them, without no doubt, worthy of studying, learning from all of them. Why? Because they are among the believers. من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر وما بدلوا تبديلا. Among the believers are those the Sahaba of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and some other people, men and women, are faithful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the covenant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They stick into it and they follow the teaching of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of them I have chosen for you last week and this week, and we'll continue with him for a while. Khalid ibn al-Walid radiyallahu anhu wa ardah. Sayfullahi wa sayfu Rasulillah. The sword of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sword of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And some of us might be wondering, why Khalid ibn al-Walid radiyallahu anhu wa ardah? We have many others. We have already discussed some of the other Sahaba, but Khalid, why in those days in particular? Simple reasons. Khalid, one of the leaders of Islam, one of the true leaders of Islam. And I'm wishing, and I'm hoping, and praying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for any of the current so-called leaders of today's to study his life and his biography. If they would like to be among the leaders of the Muslim Ummah today, to lead 1.6 billion Muslims today. Learn something from Khalid. Learn something from Khalid Ibn al-Walid radiallahu anhu arda. Especially when it comes to the leadership in military, in fighting, in defending Allah, defending Rasulullah, defending Islam and defending Muslims. Learn something from Khalid Ibn al-Walid radiallahu anhu wa arda. What else? Why we choose Khalid? Khalid is reminding us, wallahi, exactly of what is going on today for the Muslim Ummah today. For the Muslim Ummah today. In the following elements. One, Ar-Riddah. Those who declare that on the time of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda, Muhammad passed away, he's not among us anymore, so there is no need for Islam. Let's find something else to do. Especially among them, Musaylim al-Kadhab. And we'll come to him, inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen. How Khalid ibn al-Walid and the army of Muslims have fought him furiously. حروب الردة under the leadership of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda. Call it today the counter-revolution, الثورة المضادة. Or call it those who say that there is no need for Islam anymore, and let's find something else. يعني call it whatever, يعني liberalية, علمانية, شيوعية, هبابية, يعني any of these, يعني, be liberal, be socialist, be whatever, and there is no need for Islam. Let's find something else. Because nowadays we need something more effective. Islam, are you talking about 1400 years ago? Forget it. حروب الردة on the time of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله عنه وأرضاه and the rule of Khalid ibn al-Walid رضي الله عنه وأرضاه in that arena there. Reminding us of nowadays of what is happening in two parts of the Muslim world, wallahi. In Iraq and Persia, with Iran, and in Sham, in Syria, in Lebanon, in Palestine, in Jordan. And you may add to this the Gulf states. Wallahi, studying the biography of Khalid ibn al-Walid radiallahu anhu arda, and his participation to defend Allah, to defend Rasulullah, and to defend Islam, and to defend Muslim, as if we're living the same thing today. 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 And I will prove it to you, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. And finally, the war right and left, everywhere against Islam. Period. The war against Islam. Don't tell me it is that supporting that nation or that country in order to do this, or Daesh or whatever here. I say no, it is the war against Islam and Muslims. What Khalid ibn al-Walid radiallahu anhu arda'ah did. First, we have to understand and know that when he came to Islam along with some other sahaba, ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'een, Uthman ibn Talha wa Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhum, when they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they embrace Islam on the 8th year after Hijrah. Meaning 13 years in Mecca, they did not declare their Islam. In addition to 8 years in Al-Madinah, they never came to Islam. 21 years, they are fighting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam right and left. Especially Khalid ibn al-Walid, radiallahu anhu wa arda. It means that he stayed with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam only 2 years. Khalid ibn al-Walid, only 2 years. To witness with him the first major, one of the first major battles of Islam, Fath Makkah. The conquest of Mecca with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appointed him as one of the leaders of the conquest of Mecca. Khalid ibn al-Walid radiallahu anhu just came to Islam, though he came from Mecca. And now he's beside Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, beside the believers and mu'mineen to conquest Mecca, to conquer Mecca. But the disbelievers and the pagans and the Quraysh is still there. 2 years with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Entering Mecca with him, subhanallah, yani thinking and reflecting, I came from Mecca a while ago, not even a year, a few months. And now I'm coming back from Al-Madina to conquer Mecca where the disbelievers were. And I was one of them. I was supporting them. I was fighting side by side by them against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes. Khalid ibn al-Walid realized that in that wonderful scene of the conquest of Mecca, Fath Mecca, وعدullah لا يخلف الله وعده. It is the promise of Allah, and Allah will never break His promise with the true believers. That's it. It is the promise of Allah to fight for the sake of Allah, for the sake of Islam, for the sake of Rasulullah, for the sake of Muslim. That promise will never be broken. And Khalid is witnessing with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Fath Mecca, the conquest of Mecca. Bowing down his head, subhanallah rabbil alameen, being thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he guided him to Islam. And he put him in that wonderful, great situation to witness that great conquest of Mecca along with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, carrying the banner of Islam with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam under the leadership of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, couple of years later, passed away. Who succeeded him? The first caliph, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda. The biggest challenge ever, the biggest battle ever, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq faced after the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first thing, subhanallah, Harb al-Riddah. Muslims in Mecca and the outskirts of Mecca, especially very close to the Persian Empire, including Bahrain, United Arab Emirates, Oman, and okay? The first parts of the Muslim world where the Ridda came from. Those who are rebellious against Islam and rebellious against Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu wa ardah. And for Abu Bakr, he has to do something about it. Never give up. Never tell them, yes, you're right, as long as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not among us, so you can do whatever you do. No, he's in charge. He is in charge. And he had to fight back. He had to, guided by Allah, in order to be victorious by the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his guidance, inshaAllah rabbil alameen. The first thing Abu Bakr as-Siddiq has done, his eyes mainly, absolutely, without any doubt, on Abi Sulaiman Saifullah Khalid ibn al-Walid. Ya Khalid, you are the one. You are the one who's gonna lead in this war against the Murtaddin, those who are rebellious against Allah and rebellious against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as well as Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda. Armies of al-Murtaddin are preparing, training, coming from everywhere in order to fight Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and the believers in Mecca, in Medina at that time. Very dangerous situation. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was with us a while ago. And since he passed away, all of those rebellious against Islam, against Rasulullah and against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would come, yes. As I mentioned before, especially those who were living, Muslims who embrace Islam, living nearby the Persian Empire and the Roman Empire, East and West. Though the two empires were there as a huge and a great threat to Islam and Muslim at that time. They are still today. Think about it. Think about it. What is happening in Iraq and Iran? What is happening in Sham? What is happening in Europe? Persia and Roman. Different names, يعني, or different labels, or different titles. Wallahi, the same. Al-Kufru millatun wahida. The same. Coming from the same background, subhanAllah, Rabbil Alam, fighting Islam and Muslims. SubhanAllah, the ones who were leading that Harb al-Riddah against Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and Muslims at that time coming from East, especially from al-Bahrain wa Oman and al-Mahara, where United Arab Emirates is today, and the other small, tiny, little ones, Kuwait, you name it. It's exactly from where the primary forces coming to fight Islam and Muslims. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. Isn't it what we're seeing today? Or is there any difference? Wallahi, if there any difference, let me know. Maybe I'm exaggerating the situation. Khalid took over and he fought seriously, faithfully for the sake of Allah, for the sake of Islam, till he was able to defeat all of those who came against Islam and against Muslims. At that time, when you look at the leadership of Muslims, especially when you look at the situation of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu ardah, among all the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, what he did, what he was planning to do, and so on and so forth. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu ardah was determined to lead the whole battle himself, no matter what, wherever it is, whenever it is. Abu Bakr, خليفة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the first Orthodox Caliph of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. The first one who opposed that approach of Abu Bakr was Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله عنه وأرضاه, stopping him and telling him that إلى أين يا خليفة رسول الله, to where, the Caliph of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, where are you going? Why are you leaving Al-Madinah in here? Tell us what is going on. إني أقول لك ما قاله رسول الله يوم أحد. لم سيفك يا أبا بكر ولا تفجعنا بنفسك. Hold your sword, Abu Bakr, and do not go there in order to be killed. So we'll be without خليفة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. You stay in Al-Madinah. You appoint some other military leaders in order to be in that battle to defend Islam, to defend Allah, to defend the Muslims. That Ali ibn Abi Talib telling Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu wa arda. And collectively from Muslims surrounding Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu wa arda, he was convinced that to stay in Al-Madinah. But before he did so, he was able to have a wonderful military plan for the Muslim army, how they fight this battle against those al-Murtaddin. Make sure that everything is done in the right way. رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. And then he went to Khalid ibn al-Walid رضي الله عنه وأرضاه, telling him that, as Abu Bakr, telling Khalid, سمعت رسول الله يقول نعم عبد الله وأخو العشيرة خالد ابن الوليد سيف من سيوف الله سله الله على الكفار والمنافقين. الله أكبر. This is when the true leader, Abu Bakr الصديق رضي الله عنه وأرضاه, when he chose the right and the true leader to lead that battle against those who are rebellious against Allah, rebellious against Islam and Muslims. Khalid. Why? Telling him that here is what I hear from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying about you. Khalid. The best of the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you are. That's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about Khalid. True brother to all of us. You're a sword of the swords of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has appointed you as his sword against the disbelievers and hypocrites. The disbelievers and hypocrites. At the statement Abu Bakr is giving to Khalid radiallahu anhu, I wish we have leaders like Abu Bakr today. I wish we have leaders like Khalid ibn al-Walid today, in order to defend Islam and to defend Muslim and to defend Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or if they are not, they cannot be like them, to read their seerah, read their biography, read their instruction, read their maneuvering, read their tactic in war, read what they have done in order to defend Islam and Muslims. Learn something from them. No. Do not learn from Khalid. How come? How about the former Soviet Union War Academy to have our training? Or here the American Academy to learn the tactic and technique and the strategy in order to be my guest. You did and you learned and you're defeated all over. Wallahi. Wallahi, they learn a lot. And we spend billions of money on them to learn and to be educated and to be trained, and they came to lead and they failed miserably and they were defeated miserably and they still ruling us miserably too. So they won't pay any penny to learn from Khalid. Wallahi, he's teaching it there. He's teaching it there, subhanAllah. No, this is a different story. Khalid ibn al-Walid, by the help and grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by his sincerity, by his true Islam, was victorious all over all of those fronts rebellious against Islam in Harb al-Ridda. Made sure that everywhere in Arabia, all of those hypocrites and kuffar, those murtadeen, they were miserably defeated and there is no voice for them anymore. Everything is safe and secure now.